Much. Thank you so much. Great. So I'll actually get started with just talking about the channel update, what the future is of this channel, right? So yeah, let's just get started. So first of all, I have to I'm going to college starting from the 17th of August. So basically what that means is that I'll be studying, I'll be attending lectures, making notes, learning some new stuff. If you don't know, I am actually pursuing electrical engineering. I'm a second year student from BITS Pilani Goa campus. So yeah, the new semester is starting completely online. So yeah, that's what I will be doing. And because of that, I think I won't be able to put up as much effort as I'm doing right now to to actually create these videos that you watch every single week on this channel, right? So that's just something that I wanted to let you all know. It takes a lot of time to create these podcast episodes that you watch, right? Because like every single episode takes like around 3, 4, 5 hours for me to actually make and then upload on YouTube and then let all of you actually watch it. So I think that is something that I won't be able to do as much as frequently, right? So I think that I would at least be able to make one video per week. That is all that I can do. So I'm really sorry about that. I really want to, just get on my YouTube game and publish one video every single day. So yeah, I think that is what I wanted to talk to you about. And I have a lot of ideas. I have a friend of mine, and we are thinking of doing these live sessions with machine learning, right? So I'll take up your questions in just a while. I just wanted to talk to you about the channel, right? So that is what. And first of all, thank you so much for 3,000 subscribers. That just means the world to me. I never really imagined that I would hit this number so soon. So yeah, thank you so much for your support, for your help. Thank you so much. And I think we can now take some questions. TCS code Vita information, please. How many questions for 7 LPA package? I don't know, bro. I am not aware of that. Hard to qualify code Vita for TCS. I got Kazi's course for free on the internet, but would you recommend that? Would it be worth the time? Okay, so in the past 3, 4 days, what I'm doing is that I started making clones of popular websites like YouTube and apps like Tinder and TikTok. So that I'm using clever programmers, live streams that he's doing on his channel. So I think those are really amazing, and you can definitely check those out as well if you want to learn about front-end development. So that is really good. I think that those live streams are really great. I'm learning a lot from it. I'll be sharing some of my learnings with you in some future videos. So yeah, that's that. Definitely check it out. If he's offering stuff for free, you should definitely take it. Which is better, web development or machine learning? It depends on you. What do you want to do? It depends on what are your interests. Like, do you want to create? If you are more into creating something visual, then I think you should definitely go with web development. But on the other hand, if you want to, create things that are like hyped up, like machine learning and artificial intelligence and stuff, then you might want to, go to artificial intelligence. So yeah, MLH fellowship. I don't know about that. I know that this is actually a very a big hackathon that happens, Major League Hacking, but I have not registered for that yet. Are you into competitive coding? I tried. So what happened is that when I was just starting out in college, in the first month, I just took up competitive coding. I started learning about all these data structures, started implementing, I started doing some hacker rank problems. And those were fun, but then I found Python projects, and then since then I've never really looked back on. I never really started, continued my competitive coding journey. So that's what I would say. What's your plan after 4 years? I am not clear on that, right? You might think that I have my life figured out, when it is completely not true. I'm just a 19-year-old kid like you, okay? I don't know what I will be doing 4 years down the lane, but I know what I want to do today, what I want to do tomorrow, what I want to get done in this week. And I think that is really important. Don't worry about what you will do 1 or 2 years afterward, but just make sure that you have proper direction in what you are doing right now. Right. Any tips for 2021 BITSAT aspirants who is not well prepared? So I get a lot of questions on my Instagram and on YouTube as well for this. For BITSAT preparation, and I would say that you should really focus on like just Bitstart is actually not that hard, right? To be honest with you, from my own perspective, and again, that could be different for you. But for me, I feel like JE Mains is harder than Bitstart. And for Bitstart, you really have to make sure that you are attempting as many questions as possible in less amount of time. So just make sure that you try out. They are actually pretty easy questions, right? It's like they are all formula based. So you just have to make sure that you put in the values in the formula and then put the answer over there. So it's pretty simple. Are you freelancing? If yes, of what kind? And are you earning enough? Okay, I am, like, the most common way of freelancing is to go on some online website and then, just send your request and then someone else would actually accept it and they would give you some work. That is the most common way, right? I am not doing something that like that, but I am doing something else. Like I cannot tell you like right now, but I would definitely let you know in some time. I am not earning enough. Like I am earning below minimum wages. YouTube is really bad. Like if you're thinking of YouTube to earn money, don't do it. It just won't work for you, right? So that's that. Bro, best college for masters in CS specialization in AI. Are you talking about Indian college or like overall in the world, worldwide? Congratulations, bhaiya. Thank you so much, Adesh. iOS development versus Android development. It depends on you. Like if you have the money, you should definitely go get yourself a MacBook because on that you can do iOS development as well. You can also do Android development. I have not tried, mobile app development yet. I am only doing web development. So yeah, that's what I would say. What are your plans for GSOC 2021? I really want to do it, but what is happening in this semester with me is that, first of all, I have to focus on my electrical courses, which are in themselves, like it's actually a really big deal, okay? Like electrical second year, first semester is actually very hectic. At least that's what I've heard from my seniors. And I want to crack GSOC, right? Even I wanted to do it in my first year itself, but it was not possible. But definitely I want to do it and I'll definitely give it a try. Which branch are you in? I'm in electrical engineering. In BITS scholarship for first year or whole BTEC. I don't know what that means. Hello, React Native or Flutter? I have not tried React Native or Flutter, so I would not be able to give you proper advice on that. How to get internships from a tier 3 college? If there are any internship offerings that you know, please let us know. Create a Telegram or Discord so that we can connect. Yeah. Okay. So if you want to get an internship and you are from tier 3 college, you can really look up for things like AngelList is actually a pretty good platform. And if you don't know, you should actually go to LinkedIn and connect with people and then just ask them and then see if they're a high growth startup. Right, if they have, if they just got a lot of funding and they are expanding, then you can definitely reach out to them and you can be like, hey, I see that you are expanding. You just got funding by some angel investor or something. I myself, I'm a, let's just say, iOS developer. So I would love to develop an app for you. Let me know if you're interested and we can get on a call or something. So that's something that you can do. But AngelList works, right? Internshala does not work. So don't go to Internshala. I've had my negative experiences with it. So I would not recommend you to do that. So yeah, it's upon you. Binod. Very good. Awesome. How often do you do competitive coding? So I have not done competitive coding in the last 1 year. Again, I did it in the first month itself. Binod. I wanted to make the Binod tracker from a long time, but now like someone else has made it. So I'll make some different project, but anyways. Have you tried freelancing? I have not in the common sense, I have not, but yeah, like I'm just starting out sort of, I'm doing something. I'll let you know in some time. How to crack big companies full process. Okay. It's pretty simple. Okay. Get your data structures and algorithms correct. Make sure that you practice a lot of questions on LeetCode and get the how to crack the coding interview book. Right, that's like a bestseller and a must buy for all of you people who want to crack big companies. So do that and you might just make the cut. Who knows? Yeah, exactly. Harry made it. Like, any more financial podcasts on the line, like the one? Yeah. So Gaurav Sanghvi, yeah. I will be doing a podcast episode with him based on the topic should be around, I think, let me think. So that should be about how money is created and, you know, something along those lines. I don't really remember exactly, but it should be something like that. It will be pretty interesting though. What does an AI engineering do? I don't know, what do you mean? Some LinkedIn tips: connect with as many people as possible, message them, and just ask what you want to ask. Don't be afraid. Create content. Yeah, create content and then just convey what you want to talk about, and just do that every single day and you will see a lot of results. Will BitSat be online proctored this year? I don't know about that. What is your daily routine like presently? So in the past 3 days, my daily routine pretty much looks like getting up in the morning at around 7 o'clock, you know, getting ready, and then just working on creating React apps. So if you don't know, I want to learn web development. That is one thing that I'm really passionate about. So I'm just, you know, creating React apps, clones of popular apps, right? So that is what I'm doing. And that's what I do the whole day, right? And in the evening, I have some meetings and all. So that's what I spend most of my time on. Very out of context question, but do you also think that non-CS branch, like core branches are useless? I do not think that. Like every single branch has its own, you know, there's always a use case for it. But what happens is that in India, it is just not given as much importance. So that's what I feel like, but definitely there's so much scope in electrical. I wouldn't say that it is prevalent in India, but definitely I think if you can go overseas, there's definitely a lot of, you know, need for such engineers who are like chemical engineers or like, you know, biotech engineers or something. Bro, should we study abroad? Right now, if you are, first of all, because of the COVID situation, you really should not, you know, study for abroad. I would say just focus on India, but if you are really hell bent on going abroad and really studying in US, and if you can get into the top 10 schools like the Ivy Leagues or something, then you should go, I would say. But I don't know exactly. Again, I'm not experienced enough to give you advice on that part. Would you recommend buying LeetCode premium membership? I think it is definitely worth it, because if you're a fourth year or a third year student, you will literally get a lot of value out of it. So definitely check it out. It's pretty interesting. Okay, let's see. How much investment is needed to make an app if I am an app developer? Investment, like you need to have a laptop, I think, right? Like, and once you have that, you can pretty much get started, right? You have hosting services like Firebase on which you can just host it for free. And initially it can be done for free, and then you can always, if you want to make it like a startup or something, you can always approach for investors. Okay. Which is good, ECE or CSE? Depends on you. If you want the money, CSE, of course. But if you are interested into electronics, ECE. I am more interested into CSE actually. So like that's what I do. What is good for a broad bachelor, master's or PhD? I cannot answer that question. Like if I answer that question, it would look like I'm just faking it, right? Because I don't have any experience with that. Okay, what is your BitSat score? I got 330. Okay, I got 330. And then I messed up in the preference order. Okay, yeah. If you are a BitSat aspirant, don't do this mistake, okay? I did this mistake and I ended up taking electrical engineering when in reality, I could have easily gotten electrical and communication and engineering. It's not that big of a difference, I would say, but definitely something to keep in mind. Which is the best platform for BitSat preparation? It's definitely BitSat Bit by Bit, bro. Like, you should definitely check it out. Go to Harish Bhaiya's channel. He has an amazing community. Do a podcast with Stuti Khandelwal. Who is she? I don't know who she is. Anyways, how is Triple E, bro? It's not good. Like, I don't want to study. To be honest with you, I don't want to study electrical engineering. But like, I'll see how I'm able to cope up with it, and let's see what happens. Which is the best platform? Okay, electrical engineering. Which programming language you learned first? Okay, so for me, I started learning programming language back in 9th grade. You might not believe this, but like I was learning Java at that time, but it wasn't like really serious. Then I went into 11th grade and I was learning about C++. That was also not that serious. I made a couple of apps, but then it really started off on the day of JEE Advance. Okay, so what happens on JEE Advance is that I came back from home at from the center at 9 o'clock, and I instantly just pulled up my laptop, installed Jupyter Notebook, and started just learning Python from a Udemy course. So like that's what my story has been like, and so far I've learned so much from Python and just making projects, and now I'm doing front-end development. Okay, how to learn Flask from zero to advanced. Okay, so the way I learned Flask was actually going to Tech with Tim. He is a YouTuber that I've been watching a lot of videos from. He has some pretty good tutorials talking about Flask, so you should definitely give it a try. Or you can also go to Free Code Camp. Okay, Free Code Camp also has a Flask course. But then, just making projects, just make sure that you learn how routing and how to switch between pages and all that works. The most basic stuff, right? All right. Is BITS offer only first year scholarship? BITS has MCN and merit-based scholarship and merit cum need scholarship. Basically, what that means is that like if you can get like to a lot of CGPA, like 10 CGPA or something, then you are assured you might get 100% fee waiver or something. And then if you like if you have if your family's income is less than 10 LPA, I think, then you can get I think like it depends on your CGPA, right? You can watch some videos from Curious Harish. She talks about this in detail. Check it out. It's pretty good. How you have to do a collab with Harnoor Singh. Like I really want to do that. I've sent him a mail, but let's see if he responds or not. But definitely I think Harnoor is doing an amazing job, right? His whole journey has been just amazing. I started watching him back when I was in, I think I was in 11th, the ending of 11th grade, and that's when I started watching his videos, and really inspirational, I would say. Okay, well, I know Q Basic, Logo HTML, Basic JavaScript, Matter.js. That's nice. Are you having online classes? Yes, I'm having online classes on how to use GitHub and full tutorial. Yeah, sure, I might make that, but again, I won't be making as many videos as I do right now because of my online classes and my college. So that's something to just keep in mind. What's your advice for first year CSE students? Okay, first year CSE students, just chill, bro. Like, what do you need? It depends on if you are like in a tier one college or like a tier three college. If you are in a tier one college, just have fun, do whatever you want to. If you are in like a tier three college, learn some stuff, maybe. I don't know. Learn some things like maybe go to DSA and learn cognitive coding and start doing that. Or you can also go to front-end development or like mobile development, depends on what you want to do. Okay, what's your advice? Okay, that happened. Harnoor OP, definitely. How is dual degree in BITS Pilani? Okay, dual degree in BITS Pilani, I think it's really nice. And especially if you have a low score, okay, you can definitely take up a dual degree and then just study really hard in the first year itself, and you might end up getting the, what do you call it? You can get the first degree, like whatever you want, CSE, ECE, EEE, based upon your CGPA. But I think that's actually much much easier for you to do if or like when compared to, let's just say, if you are in electrical engineering, and if you want to go to computer science, that would be really hard. So yeah. Oh my God, this is spam. EEE versus ENI, which is easier? Both are the same, I would say, at least in BITS Goa. All the courses are the same, it's just some random jargon they say. I think they have one course that is different for ENI, but other than that, everything is pretty much similar. Hi, what needs to be done to get MS in CS if you did ECE in bachelor's? I think like if you have great projects, you can definitely go to universities and then just let them know that you have interest in CS and you already have an engineering degree in bachelor's, so I think that will be helpful. Can you make a video on building an app using Python? Definitely. We can do that, but I think that not a lot of people want to watch tutorials because I made tutorials on Python and not many people were interested into that. I don't know, let me know what do you think about this. please make a video on informatics Olympiad. I have no idea about that. Will web development be still relevant in the coming 5 years? Definitely. You might think that AI is coming, everything will get automated and all. But you know that the thing is, if you are in an industry and if you are like creative enough and if you have the skills and if you are like in the top 1%, you will always survive, right? There will always be a need of great web designers and web developers, okay, who can create scalable systems or websites. So that's something. Congratulations for the book, Ishan. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Like, I made that book. If you don't know, I just published my own book. It's called Crush It on LinkedIn. Basically, I talk about how to use LinkedIn and just talk about how can you create content, how can you get internships, how can you build your own brand. It's available on Amazon and Flipkart. If you want, you can definitely get the ebook or the paperback. So yeah, that's that. Thank you so much. Please make a video. Okay, that happened. And will BitSat be postponed again? I hope not. Shan Ram, your old subscriber. Thank you so much for subscribing. Thank you so much for subscribing. Like that is just amazing. What is your BitSat score? 330. Why do you choose Tripoli if you were interested in CSE? I could not get CSE, right? Like that's what happened to me. I got 330 and the cutoff was like 352 for Goa, and for like Hyderabad, it was around 3. I would say it was about 340 or something. I don't really remember much. Loved the book, read the ebook. Thank you so much. Ajinkya, thank you so much. Why you choose? Okay, that happened. What is, hey, I'm getting problem in figuring out the level of BitSat questions. Can you help? Just focus on the easy questions. Like if you go to, if you can go to JE mains questions that were in around 2005 to 2012 or 13, those are the type of questions that are asked in BitSat, I think, from my own personal experience, right? So that's that. From where did you learn digital marketing? So I have learned social media marketing, which is a subset of digital marketing. How did I learn it? Again, I just tried, I just implemented, I got an internship at a startup where I worked for it, right? So that is what I did and it really helped me out. And then I just went on to take a Coursera course. If you don't know, you can get a course for free from Coursera. I made a video on that, check it out. But basically I took that course, social media marketing, and I learned about how Facebook ads work, how targeting works, and that's just how I got started. It's really interesting. Like I am not like a guru in that, but I'm still learning, right? I try to create campaigns and just test things and see how well it works. So there's that. Ishan, do you know me? You want to talk on Insta? Definitely, bro. Ajinkya. How can a ECE do what they do? Okay, I don't understand what you mean. Thank you a lot. Welcome. Is it harder to get into bits or is it more difficult to survive there once you get in? I don't know what to tell you. Like, it's easier to get in bits for me. It's harder to survive there, I would say, definitely. And that's just my own personal opinion. Like, I have like a really trash CGPA. If you don't know, I have like 6 CGPA and it's not good. Okay, like I really have to work hard on studying and making sure that I get like really good grades, and only then will I be able to like sit for some better companies in CSE and electrical or like CSE, right? Okay, let's see. What is harder to get into, MIT or BitSCOA? NIT or, okay. It depends on you. It depends on like what your skill is. Like there is no one answer that I can give you. Your total book sales, I offered it for free to everyone in the first 2 weeks, and around like 500 people got the book. So that was really amazing. People were getting so much value out of it. And that is what really motivates me, right? Like I just get up and I wanted to create something. Like I want to create value for people, right? Through my videos, through my written content on LinkedIn, through my book. And so, yeah, but after that, I think like I got like 6-7 sales, but it definitely is increasing every single month. What is harder to get into? Okay, congratulations. Thank you so much. Which company is currently visiting for bids for internship? A lot of companies are visiting, I think. Like from what I have heard from my first year, from my like fourth year, like seniors, a lot of companies are coming. So yeah, definitely. What were some things you wished you knew when you were in 9th and 10th? Oh man, like Riddhi is asking this question. I hope, like, I wish I knew that it's not a big deal if you, even if you like don't get into like IITs, it's not the end of the world. So just keep that in mind if you don't get into IITs. I also have 6 CGPA. Awesome, bro. 6 CGPA. Amazing. What can ECE do? What does that even mean? If I may ask, why do you take a personal development course rather than a professional development course? What exactly do you mean? Please elaborate. Can Ryzen 5 3500U run programming and Photoshop? Okay, so programming, I think any laptop can run programming. You don't have to worry about that, right? But if you really want to do Photoshop and some, you know, graphic design work, I think you should really focus on 4000 series from the Ryzen 5. But just look up for the benchmarks and see on YouTube if they have done some tests on using, you know, Photoshop and Illustrator and, you know, InDesign or something. So any startup plans? So I'm actually working for a college startup right now, and I have a meeting for that in just like 30 minutes from now. So that's that. But for me personally, I already have a business, sort of, you can call it. Basically, what I do is that I help people get started with podcasting. I started it like 2 months ago, and we already have the first batch of people that learned podcasting, you know, the equipment over here, right? And, you know, just editing videos and all that. So like, that's what I taught them. And it was just a really good experience. I learned a lot about teaching people, communicating with people. So that is what my plan was for the startup. It's not like a tech startup, like I'm building some sort of website, like something, but definitely, like, that's what I have done so far. But definitely after my, you know, with my college starting out, I don't think I will be able to focus much on that. So yeah, college is ruining everything for me. Explain about branch changing firm. How easy, wait a minute, oh my God. Explain about branch. How easy is it to get MSc Physics dual degree this year? Make sure that you get like around 300 or something, 310, and you will be safe if you want to get MSc Physics in BITSCOA. Explain about branch changing. Oh my God, this is spam. Bro, I'm full stack web developer and cross platform. Need internships? Go to AngelList. AngelList is the best place if you want internships, or just network with people. Look at the top startups that got like YC funded or something, and then just approach them. Say like, if you don't know what YC is like Y Combinator. It is like an accelerator. They fund startups. Just approach them and just tell them that, hey, I would like to get an internship at your place. Let me know if you have any open spots. Is it worth buying a MacBook for coding and programming, or will a Windows laptop suffice for BTEC in CSE? What I think is that if you can afford it, you should definitely go for it. But like, obviously I could not. So I have like this Acer gaming laptop, which I use for editing, for some design work as well. So yeah, I think you should definitely invest in a MacBook. I don't have the funds. Like, if you have, you should definitely try it out. Web developer, Android developer, any suggestions for internships? Second year COE. Google Colab is best for programming. Definitely, if you want to do some visualizations and if you want to go into Python, definitely. How we choose our branch and bits. What are easy? Okay. Let me know if you have any more questions, guys. I have a meeting scheduled in 30 minutes. So I was just wondering when the number of watches will be in lakhs. Okay. It will happen soon, don't worry. EC at Hyderabad or Triple E at Goa? Triple E at Goa, obviously. Goa is like the best place for you to be in. Like, BITS Goa is better than BITS Hyderabad. My personal opinion, no offense. Okay, do a podcast with Kalpit Veerwal. Yo, I have this story with him. Like, so I actually mailed him, right? And he replied back and he was like, sure, we can do a podcast episode. And then I was like, okay, cool. Let me know when you can do that. And then he stopped responding. I don't know what happened, but definitely I would love to have him on the show. If you have ever talked with him, let him know that I would be happy to talk to him and just learn from him. How did he get started? What is the journey like? And like, what were the challenges that he faced? So yeah, definitely do a podcast with Kalpit Veerwal. Okay. Like I meant, do softwares provided by college support Mac? Yeah, so I think that if you're into mechanical engineering, I've heard that there are some softwares that you might not be able to play on Mac, but then you can always go to like things like we have our own lab, right? We have our own computer lab, so that you can go there and you can practice over there if you want to. Depends on you. Mic for podcast, I use this Mayono mic, right? I have the link to it in the description. If you want to buy it, you can check it out. It's actually really good. Like, I just bought it after 6 months of doing podcasting, which is crazy. But again, I just wanted to make sure that I really want to do this consistently and I will not like, procrastinate or something. But yeah, this is a great mic that you can check out. It's actually pretty budget friendly. Suggestions for me, I'm a second year computer engineering student. Have fun and use LinkedIn and just learn about web development. Or if you decide what you want to do, if you want to go into web development or like mobile development, or do you want to do things like DSA, it depends on you. Where to find new startups for internships? AngelList, like I should tap it over here, type it over here, right? AngelList is the way to go. Which is better for physics, Goa or Hyderabad? I don't know, to be honest. I don't know about that. You can look at other people from like Harish Bhaiya se pooch lo like something, but I don't really know about that. Thank you so much, Harshvardhan. Thank you so much. Which is better for physics, Goa or Hyderabad? If you learn TensorFlow or Python for ML AI alone with web dev, can you sustain it still and it still be chilled? I need insight about its third time I'm typing it. I don't understand what you want to say, bro. Will web developers have scope in future? Yes, they will, for sure. Everyone just read Crush It on LinkedIn. Definitely, definitely check it out. The link is in the description. Will I also have a meeting now, maybe? Okay, guys. So yeah, thank you so much for joining here. Again, all of these things that I'm doing will be halted for now because of my college. I will be focusing on that because I have to get good CG or else I'm screwed. Right, so that's what I have to do. I'll just take 5 more minutes and then we'll wrap it up. I'm in 12th standard. I just started coding by watching Code with Harry, C programming. That is really good. Like, Code with Harry has this like 10-hour course in Hindi in C, and I think that is definitely something that you can check out. It's amazing. I'm in 12th standard, started. Okay, how to grow YouTube channel? I don't know. Just create content. Consistency is the best way to do it. Please tell me mistakes you made during IIT JEE prep. Okay, I might make videos on this later, but basically the mistakes I made is that I became egoistic by the end of 11th grade because I was doing really good. I was like, in my coaching, I was like the top 5 people in that area. Okay, in Fidji, if you don't know. So I was doing really well and people were like, you will get a really good rank. And then I got like egoistic or something and I stopped studying as hard as I was doing in 11th grade. But yeah, I don't really regret that. Whatever. CSE, but finally I get ECE, but I'm learning programming. The difference, I am in tier 3 college. If you're in tier 3 college, you should definitely, just focus on projects and networking. If you can just do these two things, you will be much better off, I think. Have you ever gotten a reply of cold email from CEOs, COOs, CFOs? I have definitely gotten the replies, but it depends on you. Like, what do you mean by CEOs? Do you mean like people like Google or something? So yeah, definitely not from them, but like definitely for the smaller startups that were started from like Bitsian founders. I've definitely gotten the chance to talk to them. What was your JEE rank? My JEE rank, JEE Advance, was around 20,000. So yeah, BitSat preparation tips. Go to like BitSat bit by bit, bro. They'll help you out a lot. Open College versus Tier 3. Tier 3, I would say. Tier 3. How cool is Curious Harish? I don't know. Distance learning versus Tier 3 college. Tier 3, like, is that even a question? I am also interested in CSE, got learning Tier 3. Okay. So I think I'm just gonna wrap it up over here. Thank you so much for joining me. At the end, I just want to tell you thank you so much for your support. I've learned a lot in this journey of creating content. If you want to ask any more questions, you can reach out to me on Instagram at ishansharma7390. I'll just pop it up over here. Right, I am there for you. If you have any questions, definitely let me know. I will answer them over there. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next videos. Don't be like, why am I not uploading videos? I have to really focus on studies right now. Okay, so yeah, thank you so much, and I'll see you. Bye-bye.